There's a number of ways that we might consider risk in this scenario. Let's look at first this idea of what's the chance that you might lose it all. So you put out your bets on the 1,000 tables, the coins are flipped. In that event, what's the chance you lose all of your money? In the single bet case, where you put all of your money on a single table and the outcome is determined by the flip of a single coin, remember, even though it's biased in your favor, there still is a 49% chance it'll come out against you. So if you put all your money on a single table for one coin, there's a 49% chance that you'll lose all of it. That's pretty high. I mean, consider that in the context of, you know, would you put your savings account on a single bet like that? Now, I want you to think a little bit. Consider the multi-bet case where we put one token on each of the 1,000 tables. So there's 1,000 coin flips, and our return is determined by the result of all of those individual 1,000 coin flips. What is the chance that we would lose it all in that case? Well, the answer to that is that it's the probability that we lose on the first table times the probability that we lose on the second table times the probability we lose on the third. And as you can see, we do this for all of the 1,000 tables and multiply those probabilities all together. And that's the probability we would lose everything in that multi-bet scenario. That is a very, very small number. It's 0.49 to the 1,000th power. How small is it? Let's try and calculate it on a calculator. So it's 0.49 raised to the 1,000th power. Let's see how small that is. It's so small, it's not even a number. That's how small it is. Okay, let's look at another way to evaluate risk.